When we launched our first satellite in the 1950s, we entered the space age. Since then, we've heavily relied on satellite systems like GPS to guide ambulances, firefighters, aircraft, even your Uber Eats. As a technological society, we really need space. But all of this is in danger. Every satellite that goes in orbit could destroy this whole system. Because at the same time we enter the space age, we also enter the age of space junk. Now, space junk isn't any old junk. It's an uncontrolled object or debris in Earth orbit, and it is a special kind of dangerous because it can move around Earth at up to 25,000 kilometers an hour. Now, at these speeds, even a fleck of paint carries the energy of a bullet. And since there isn't too much in space, junk like satellites and debris can hang around up there a long time at this immense speed. Unless, of course, it crashes into another satellite, which makes more debris, which can crash into more satellites and so on. This is a massive problem, and it's already started. In my top right figure, you can see an illustration of just how many objects are already crowding Earth's orbit. If this gets even worse, it could leave us here trapped on Earth under this thick cloud of deadly projectiles. This would be the end of our satellite systems. Just imagine, no Google Maps, no GPS, and no space exploration. So what do we do? Basically, space traffic management, or space situational awareness, where we spot satellites and track them across the sky to predict collisions with just enough time for satellites to move out of the way. But this isn't easy. We don't actually know where all our satellites are or where all the debris is. We lose track all the time. There are also satellites that don't want to be found. All we can do is to try and detect them with telescopes and radar, which work mostly well, but can be very expensive, require a lot of power, and can be a little slow to react. So we need more solutions. In neuromorphic engineering, we make solutions inspired by how biology solves problems using machines like the brain. This is my research. I detect and track satellites using high-speed, power-efficient neuromorphic cameras mounted on our telescopes. On my top left figure, the neuromorphic camera can see satellites through the telescope by how the brightness of the sky changes and produces a very fast spike or pulse when it happens, much like the neurons in our brain. To detect and track satellites with these spikes, I built a neuromorphic machine learning algorithm that quickly detects and learns the rough appearance of satellites from the neuromorphic camera within microseconds of it appearing. The satellite is then followed by the predictive tracker to give us the trajectory of the satellite, which we can use to predict a possible crash between other objects in orbit. Using these new neuromorphic algorithms, we can prevent satellite collisions with more efficient, more reactive space monitoring. Space is a natural resource that we need to protect. The future of our satellites, GPS, and space travel all rely on these efforts. Thank you.